In this session, we'll look at some general aspects of this course, how this course is positioned within the program in process engineering, and then what does really process engineering mean, and what are the requirements of an engineering graduate in terms of the graduate attributes. Now first, let's look at what does a process mean. If we very loosely put, a process can be considered as a systematic combination of operations to produce useful products from available raw materials. Now let's look at these three aspects mentioned here. The systematic combination that should follow some engineering principles. You should produce something useful, and the raw materials should be available. You cannot dream to produce something out of something that does not exist. Now we looked at the process part. What is engineering means then? Now, according to Engineers Canada, the body that governs the engineering profession in Canada, the definition is that the practice of engineering refers to any act of planning, designing, composing, evaluating, advising, reporting, directing, supervising, or managing any of the foregoing that requires the application of engineering principles. And the objective is that concerns the safeguarding of life, health, property, economic interest, the public welfare, or the environment. Now, this is a mouthful definition. However, keeping in mind the overall profession from the governing body that governs the profession from their perspective. Now, the term used there was engineering principles. What are these engineering principles mean? So, the engineering principle means the professional application of the principles of mathematics, chemistry, physics, or any related applied subject. So, here the emphasis is given on the application aspect of different subject, and specifically mathematics, physics, and chemistry. These three are specifically emphasized. Now, process engineering as a program, as an engineering discipline, it prepares students as practicing engineers through teaching of engineering principles relevant to the process industries. Now, what are those process industries? We see that within the domain of process industries, we have chemicals, petrochemicals, biochemicals, mineral processing, petroleum processing, food, pharmaceuticals, cosmetics, minerals, pulp and papers, and many more. Process industries really captures a very wide spectrum of industry. Now, if we look at a process, you can see that at the heart of many processes, we have a reactor or a set of reactors. Then separation units. There are mixing units, there are heat exchangers, there are transportation units, and there are size reduction units as well, specifically for the mineral industry, for pharmaceuticals, for food industry, where solid handling is one of the major concerns. Now, within the domain of process engineering program, different subjects, they cover different topics. For example, the chemical reaction engineering, it covers chemical kinetics and the reactor design part. The mass transfer course covers the separations involving mass transfer. The heat transfer covers the basic aspect of heat transfer and the design of heat exchangers. The unit operations cover the operations involving the physical changes. And fluid mechanics course covers the fluid transformation. Now, this process equipment design one, this course is mainly address the issue of unit operations. Now, again, let's look at what are the unit operations. So, process can be considered as a sequence of physical changes and chemical reactions. It can be subdivided into a number of steps which are performed sequentially to transform some starting materials into final products. So, going back to the definition that you looked at, the process is a systematic combination of operations. In other words, a process is a sequence of a set of operations. A unit operation is one of the sequence in this step. The terms refers to some physical transformation of different streams as opposed to the chemical transformations. Unit operations are primarily physical steps for preparing reactants, separating products, recycling unreacted products, energy transfer. Now the categorization of unit operation involves that within the domain of fluid flow process, we have fluid transport, fluidization, mixing of solid with fluid. Within the domain of heat transfer, we have heating, cooling, evaporation, and condensation operations. In mass transfer, absorption, distillation, extraction, adsorption, these are considered, as well as what is called this drying. Now there are some thermodynamic processes as well, liquefaction and refrigeration. These are also unit operations, as well as the mechanical processes typically involving solids, crushing, sieving, and transportation of solids. All these are within the domain of unit operations. Now in this course, our approach will be to use the scientific principles learned in fluid mechanics, mass and heat transfer, thermodynamics, etc., and we'll use the experimentation to determine parameters of equipment and different devices. Now, what are the responsibilities of process engineers? We looked at the definition of engineering. Now, specifically look at from the perspective of process engineer, what are their job? So, developing a process, designing a process, detailed engineering of a process, operating the process, and maintenance and troubleshooting. So, you can look at from the planning all the way to the maintenance. Process engineers are involved. In this course, we'll understand the basic operating principles of specific equipment. We will use many equations derived in other courses, and we'll carry on design calculations using scientific and engineering principles. As a to-be engineering graduate, you also need to understand what are the requirements set by Engineers Canada. So Engineers Canada requires that a graduate from an engineering program should have these 12 attributes. Okay. So I have subcategorized these 12 attributes into three. One is the engineering attributes, one is the practicing attributes, another is what is called this interacting attributes. The engineering attributes involves the knowledge base, which is basically knowledge about all different aspects of that particular engineering discipline. Problem analysis, meaning that a graduate should be able to analyze problems. Investigation. A graduate should be able to investigate a problem to design proper solution. A graduate should also be able to use different tools to solve problems. Consider the economics and project management aspect. And more, most importantly, the design of engineering equipment and plan. Within the domain of practicing, they should learn the aspect of professionalism, ethics and equity, and lifelong learning, which is one of the attributes I would say very important for the graduate of these days. Within the domain of interacting, an engineering graduate should be able to understand the impact of engineering to society and the environment, should be able to work individually as well as a team, and also should be able to communicate in writing and verbally to other team members as well as to the general public. So as a to be graduate, you should think about these aspects, not only the contents of the course, rather how these different attributes are developed through understanding of the course material. So in summary, in this session we learned about what is engineering, what is process engineering, what are engineers responsible for, and then how this course is positioned within the program of process engineering. Finally, we learned about what are the attributes that the graduates of a program should have. Thank you.